The thing with Kiewit is they're ginormous, ginormous and capable. And they have a wonderful process and discipline about how they go about engineering and then building things. And importantly, they have the capability to do more than one project all at once. And of course, when we have growth plans like we have, that becomes really, really important. We can do net zero, one, two, three, whatever. These guys, they hire like 1,000 engineers a year kind of a place.
In this video, we will look closer at Gevo's partnership with Kiewit. In October of 2021, Gevo announced it had engaged Kiewit Energy Group to lead a front-end engineering design effort for its Net Zero One project.
We like working with them, what we've seen so far, and we've been working on them for months, many, many months now. We just didn't get a chance to talk about it publicly.
According to Forbes, Kiewit is one of North America's largest and most respected engineering and construction organizations, with its roots dating back to 1884. With $12.5 billion in revenue and 27,000 employees, Kiewit currently ranks as number 21 on Forbes' list of America's largest private companies.
Since 1884, Kiewit has built some of the largest and most complex construction and engineering projects in the Western Hemisphere. Today, our work extends across 7 core markets, each of which has allowed our company to construct and engineer projects that have helped improve and shape the landscape of North America and beyond. With a strong local presence and a vast network of resources, Kiewit's ability to mobilize high-performing construction and engineering teams helps us provide best-in-class solutions for clients across North America. Our construction-focused engineering approach keeps constructability in mind at every step, leveraging over 135 years of self-performed construction experience to help our clients realize best-for-project solutions that reflect real schedules and real costs. With proven experience at any stage of the project development lifecycle, our early contractor involvement and ability to self-perform our work drive greater project certainty and more value for clients. From small jobs to multi-billion dollar mega projects. As one of ENR's top ranked contractors, Kiewit has long established a formula for operational success. Kiewit's people, technology, and vast network of resources are dedicated to serving our clients, delivering strong results, and helping Kiewit move closer to its goal of being the best contracting organization on Earth.
There's some major shifts going on in the power delivery market today. We're moving away from a central power station and more to distributed generation. Now, the reason for that is the evolving needs of power generation, from fossil fuels to renewables. Kiewit delivers a broad spectrum of services, not only transmission and substations. We also do electric vehicle charging, solar PV and wind interconnects, front-end engineering and design, consulting-type services, as well as operations and startup. If I was to sum up what we do at Kiewit and why it's important, it's really delivering. Delivering on our projects, how we execute them successfully through schedule and cost certainty, and to our people. But they deliver projects transparently, thoroughly, and completely. It's a central theme of what Kiewit Power Delivery does every day.
They're transparent when issues arise. They have been able to deliver on schedule within the accuracy of the bid, and more importantly, providing the quality that we expect for our customers.
Kiewit is one of the largest construction companies in the world, and they're EPC company too, you know, engineering, procurement, construction company in the world. These are a giant. They've done tons of work over the years with petrochemical companies, and I'm really happy to have them. And because these guys have the ability to carry out and execute multiple projects at once, that's an important factor, you know, when you start thinking about what we're trying to do and how are we going to grow. And these guys have a reputation of being the best in the industry.
So let's go to Kiewit.com and see just exactly what this company is capable of. They deliver offshore projects such as oil platforms. They do gas processing and pipeline facilities, liquid natural gas. Just look at the complexity in this structure. Petrochemical facilities, and they also have vast experience in the refining and renewable fuels field. Today, Kiewit is providing engineering and construction services for alternative renewable energy and fuels, as well as carbon capture projects. The consortium of Kiewit subsidiary, TIC, and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries America engineered, procured, and constructed the Petronova carbon capture project, the first in the US. The project was completed under budget and ahead of schedule, and won Power Magazine's Plan of the Year in 2017. And Kiewit is also experienced in wind farms.
Kiewit? Oh, I'm tickled to have these guys. They're really, really, really good. And yeah, we expect them to be the EPC wrap company. What that means is they're the ones who go build the plant at a price and guarantee the price and that the plant works. That's what they are. And so we've still got to finish off our engineering. And then we got to finish off the EPC wrap. We still got to rate, you know, align the debt lenders, and they need to see what the EPC wrap looks like. And so the EPC company is saying that we can build it for this price, this time frame, and it'll work. And then they're on the hook to make it work if there was a problem. That's what an EPC company does.
But it's not entirely certain that Kiewit will build a net zero one plant. Gevo also has the opportunity to make a procurement for the construction itself to negotiate the best price.
I had investors ask me, some of the people on these questions we get sent in, they're retail guys, well, aren't you going to get your butt handed to you because you're working with just one company? No, we're not quite that stupid. We're going to be careful here and make sure that we're getting the best deal for our money. Because like I said, you know, we have to spend a big chunk of our cash to go make this project happen. We're not going to waste it. And then the normal way of doing stuff, you put stuff out for bid, right? That is the normal way of doing this. And you'd say to the EPC contractors, you know, let's have several of you bid against each other. That's how you get the best deal for the EPC. That's all fair game for us. And like I said, I want more gallons. Because the demand is bigger and everyone asks me, well, you're gonna build another net zero plant right away? Well, how about this? We get this one sized right first. It isn't like this is serial number 100. This is not what we're building here. It's serial number one, you know? And so everything has to be gone over with the fine tooth comb. The equipment itself is about $200 million. But we put out about $800 million, okay? As an installed capital cost for including everything. Right? So, you know, we're going to wrestle about that. It does add time to it, but it's money well spent. Or let me say that differently. It's not money spent, it's money delayed. And in the end, it leads to a better overall result and less capital being spent, which of course, that's the most important thing.
Of course, there are challenges ahead. This is the first plant of its kind. But like Pat is saying, to get it right is crucial. And if Gevo can increase Net Zero One's production capacity without spending more capital, it may be worth a minor delay at this stage, because that will save them a lot of time and money in the future and help the company grow bigger sooner. Rushing forward could lead to bad decisions along the way that later on could hinder them to expand even further. I would love to hear your thoughts on this. Please share them in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, please press the like button. And if you're thirsty for more Gevo-related due diligence, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I make these videos just to inform and entertain, and you should not consider them as any kind of financial advice. That's all I have for now. Until next time, bye-bye.